हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल पैथोलॉजी मास्टर। माइसेल्फ डॉक्टर पार्थ एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग मिथबस्टर्स फॉर द COVID-19 इन्फेक्शन। वी विल डिस्कस सम ऑफ द मिसकंसेप्शंस रिगार्डिंग द COVID-19। दिस एंटायर प्रेजेंटेशन इज प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वेबसाइट, सो यू कैन कंसिडर इट एज एन ऑथेंटिक बिकॉज इट इज एंटायरली प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वेबसाइट। Now before I start my today's discussion, I request you to see the video regarding the prevention of the novel coronavirus and the 7 steps of hand washing that was posted before few days by me in this website. Sorry, in my channel. So you can see these two videos first, so it will be easy to understand the myth regarding the coronavirus infection. So let's start the today's topic of discussion, that are misconceptions of the COVID-19. So the first myth is that hydroxychloroquine cure the COVID-19. So remember guys, it is the fact that hydroxychloroquine or any other drug cannot treat the COVID-19 infection. It has not been licensed by the WHO, right? However, hydroxychloroquine is producing the acidic environment. It produces the acidic pH, that's why the COVID virus cannot survive in that medium. However, it has not been proved entirely. So without doctor advice, it is not advisable to take the hydroxychloroquine because it can produce the serious side effects and the illness. Particularly, it lead to QT interval prolongation. So before starting this medication, EKG investigation must be done, and that's why it should be taken after doctor advice only. This drug is being prescribed in the India, so ICMR guidelines prefer the use of hydroxychloroquine in the COVID patient. It can be used for the prevention as well, but it is not entirely proved, so it doesn't cure the COVID-19 infection. However, you can take this medicine only if your doctor agree. Okay, second myth. So, some people believe that adding the paper to the meal will cure your COVID-19 infection, but it is totally false belief. The fact is that adding the paper to your soup or other meal will not prevent or cure the COVID-19. So, if you will add this paper into your soup or meal, then it will not cure the COVID-19. It can only make your food tasty. The best way of prevention of the coronavirus is to maintain the social distance, maintain the physical distance, means you have to keep 1 meter distance from the other individual, and frequent hand washing is the effective way to prevent the infection from the COVID. You can see my video regarding prevention of the coronavirus regarding that. Okay, guys, it is the fact that COVID-19 is not transmitted through the house fly. Remember that your house fly will not transmit the COVID-19. There is no evidence that coronavirus is transmitted through the house fly. So it's just a misconception. Remember that it will not be transmitted through house fly. You know very well that COVID-19 is transmitted through the respiratory route, right? The virus that caused the COVID-19 spread primarily through the droplets that will be generated when the infected person cough, sneeze or speak. So it will be transmitted if you touch the contaminated surface, and then you will touch your eye, nose or mouth, and you will not do the hand washing, then it can be transmitted. Or it can be transmitted through respiratory route. However, it cannot be transmitted by house fly. Okay, introducing a bleach or any disinfectant into your body doesn't prevent the COVID. Remember guys, if you spray or if you introduce the bleach into your body, will not protect you against the COVID-19 infection, and in fact it can be very dangerous for your health. It can cause irritation to your skin and eye, so it should not be introduced into your body. However, you can clean the surface, you can do the mopping, with this bleach solution. Diluted hypochlorite can be used for mopping and it can be used to clean the surface, but not to clean your body or not to introduce into your body. The sodium hypochlorite is very effective in killing the virus if it is applied to the surface. So you can clean the surface with the bleach, but don't inject or spray over your body. Okay, alcohol drinking doesn't prevent or cure the COVID-19. You have to remember that any form of alcohol, methanol, ethanol or bleach will not prevent or cure the COVID-19, and it can be extremely dangerous. You know very well that excessive alcohol intake will damage your liver. It can damage your liver. So don't take it excessively. It will not cure the COVID-19. Okay, mobile network doesn't spread the COVID-19 infection. It is a well-known fact that 5G mobile network will not spread the COVID-19. The misconception is there that 5G mobile network can transmit the infection, but you have to remember that virus cannot travel on the radio waves or mobile network. So it will not spread through the 5G mobile networks. Remember that. It will only spread through the respiratory droplets and through the contaminated surface, by touching to the contaminated surface. This is the only two way of spread. It will not spread through mobile network. Okay, you have to remember that sun exposure doesn't cure your COVID-19 infection. Exposing yourself to the sun or to the temperature above the 25 degree will not prevent or cure the COVID-19 infection. So you have to remember that putting yourself in the hot weather will not prevent the COVID-19, because the countries with the hot weather have reported the cases of COVID-19, like that of India, where the temperature is very high and the humidity is also there. In spite of that, COVID-19 is spreading in India. So sun exposure doesn't cure the COVID-19. Okay, you can recover from the COVID and it's not the lifetime disease. Some believe that once you got the COVID-19 infection, you will have the infection for the lifetime. But guys, it is not the fact. It is totally misconception. It is not the lifetime disease. Once you got the disease, you can recover and you can develop the antibody against the COVID virus. So don't worry about that. The ability to hold breath for the 10 seconds will not, that doesn't mean that you are free from corona. Some people believe that being able to hold the breath for 10 seconds or more means you are free from corona, but it is not like that. In fact, it can be dangerous, and some people may develop a more severe form of disease, like that of pneumonia. The only way to detect the coronavirus is the laboratory test, particularly polymerase chain reaction. The PCR testing, RT-PCR testing, is the only way to detect the virus. The ability to hold breath for 10 seconds doesn't mean you don't have the coronavirus infection. So don't practice it at home. Okay, alcohol, as we have discussed, alcohol drinking doesn't prevent the COVID infection. The frequent or excessive alcohol consumption can increase your risk of health problem. Particularly, it can damage your liver. So it will not prevent you from the infection, but in fact it can damage your internal organs. So don't try excessive alcohol drinking for curing the COVID-19. Guys, you have to remember that COVID can be transmitted in a hot, humid climate as well, like that in the India. It can be transmitted in any climate, including areas with a hot and humid weather. Okay, cold weather cannot prevent the COVID-19 spread. You have to remember that cold weather and the snow cannot kill the new coronavirus. There is no reason to believe that cold weather will kill the virus, right? The normal human body temperature is around the 36.5 degrees centigrade and 37 degrees centigrade, regardless the external temperature. The most effective way is to clean your hand, to wear the mask and make the physical distance. That is the only way to prevent the COVID spread. The cold weather will not be helpful. Okay, You also have to remember that hot bath doesn't prevent the COVID spread. If you are taking the hot bath regularly, then it doesn't mean that you are immune to coronavirus infection. However, taking the frequent bath can helpful to remove the virus from your body. If you have the virus over your skin, then by taking the bath, it can be removed. However, frequent hot bath will not prevent the COVID-19 spread. So regular bath is advisable, but don't take excessive hot bath because it can damage your skin. Okay, you have to remember that new coronavirus, this COVID-19, will not spread through the mosquito bite, right? It will not spread through the mosquito. So it doesn't develop like that of dengue or malaria, right? The mosquito is not at all responsible for the COVID-19. You can acquire the coronavirus infection only through touching the contaminated surface or by the respiratory route. Okay. One question is there, are hand dryer effective in cleaning the novel coronavirus? So guys, the answer is no. The hand dryers are not effective in killing the new novel coronavirus. To protect yourself against the new coronavirus, you should frequently do the hand washing, or you can clean your hand with the alcohol-based sanitizer, or you can wash them with the soap and water. So the hand dryer is not an effective way to killing the coronavirus. In fact, the effective way is to clean your hand with the soap and water, or use the hand sanitizer. Okay, UV-light should not be used as a hand disinfectant. It is the fact that ultraviolet radiation can cause the skin irritation and it can damage your eye. So it should not be used to disinfect your hand or the other areas of your skin. It will not kill the coronavirus, so don't practice it. In fact, I should suggest that you should clean your hand with the soap and water, or you can use alcohol-based sanitizer. You can see my video regarding prevention of coronavirus for that. Okay, is thermal scanner effective in detecting the corona? That might be the question for many people, that how effective are the thermal scanner in detecting the people infected with the new coronavirus. So guys, first of all, you have to remember that thermal scanner is used to detect your body temperature. So the fever can be detected by this thermal scanner, and you know very well that fever is one of the symptoms of coronavirus infection. But guys, once you got infected with coronavirus, the fever can develop after 2 to 10 days. It can develop between the 2 to 10 days, right? So until then, the thermal scanner cannot detect your fever, because you don't have the fever until 10 days sometime. And guys, all the patients might not have fever as well, and there are many causes for fever as well. So we can say that thermal scanner is one of the screening method for detecting the coronavirus symptom, but it cannot be used as a testing method for the coronavirus. So it can detect who have developed a fever. So you can do the screening, and those who have the high body temperature, those who have the fever, can be get tested for the corona. Okay, do pneumonia vaccine protect against the COVID? You might have questioned that pneumonia vaccines like that of pneumococcal vaccine or hemophilus influenza vaccine can protect you from corona. So answer is no. The vaccine for the COVID virus has not been developed yet, and the researchers are trying to develop the vaccine against the coronavirus. In the future, it might be available, but until now, it is not available. Okay, second myth is that, can nose rinsing prevent the corona infection? Some believe that if you rinse your nose regularly, right, then you are free, then you can be free from the corona infection, but it is not the fact. The answer is no. There is no evidence that regularly rinsing the nose with the saline will be protective for the infection from the new coronavirus. There is a limited evidence that rinsing the nose with the saline can help the people from recover more quickly from the cold, right? So it can be effective measures for the treatment of common cold, but it will not prevent the corona infection. It has not been proved yet. So regular rinsing your nose has not shown to prevent the respiratory infection. So it cannot prevent the corona infection. Okay, can garlic intake prevent the corona infection? So guys, you have to remember that garlic is a very good and healthy food that is having the antimicrobial property. So definitely it will maintain your good respiratory hygiene. But there is no evidence that high intake of garlic will prevent you from corona infection. Okay, which group are infected by the corona? Does coronavirus affect old people only, or it affect the young people only? So you have to remember that coronavirus can infect all age groups, starting from the children, from the adult, and it can infect the old age group as well. However, it has been observed that in the old age group people and in the people with the pre-existing comorbidity like that of respiratory illness, asthma, those who have the asthma, those who have the diabetes, those who have the hypertension has shown the high mortality. So the old age group people and the people with pre-existing medical condition like that of asthma, diabetes, hypertension or any form of cardiac disease are more vulnerable for becoming the severely ill with this virus, and mortality is high in such individual. The death rate or mortality rate is very low in young people. So young people recover fast. It has been observed that death is very rare in young people with no morbidity. If there is a no comorbid condition and the patient is young, then prognosis is very good. Okay, are antibiotic effective in killing the coronavirus? So answer is obviously no. The antibiotic doesn't work against the virus. However, the antibiotic intake can prevent the secondary infection from the bacteria, and that's why azithromycin is widely used in the coronavirus patients. It is one of the drugs that is used in novel coronavirus infection. Okay, are there any specific medicine to treat the corona? So our final myth is there that are there any specific medicine to treat the corona infection? So guys, you have to remember that till date there is no specific medicine recommended to prevent or treat the new coronavirus. Hydroxychloroquine and some of the antiviral drugs that is used in HIV are being used for treating the coronavirus infection, but it has not been proved. So only you have to do the supportive care, and you can use some of the hydroxychloroquine and other antiviral drug as per your protocol. But no specific drug is available until now that specifically treat the coronavirus infection. The WHO is trying to do the more research and trying to develop a specific medicine against the corona. So in the future it might be available, but until now the specific medicine to treat the corona is not available. So guys, this is all about the Mythbusters for the COVID-19 infection. So I hope that it might be beneficial to you in making your fundamentals clear regarding how coronavirus spreads, and your misconceptions might get removed through this lecture. I again recommend to you that see my video regarding the prevention of novel coronavirus for the more knowledge. So guys, thank you for your time, and subscribe my channel if you like my video. See you soon in the next video. Thank you very much.